AEW's Christian Cage has worn many hats in his illustrious career. Now add singing to the list. We're going to get into carpool karaoke, but Christian, and thank you. Hey, what's next for you? American Idol, The Voice?
Maybe both. I don't know. There's also Canadian Idol, so I could, if I don't make it here, I could always go up to Canada and get on Canadian Idol as well. So I've got options.
Hey, so this is so awesome. So I want to read a little bit about carpool karaoke and then obviously get your reaction on this. Two cars full of AEW stars will appear in the new season of Apple TV Plus's Carpool Karaoke, the series, which premieres on May 27th. Now, this is going to be exciting. You're going to have big names from AEW hitting the road in Minneapolis, playing Mindbeld and tearing through a songbook from Pat Benatar to DMX. Car one, driver Will Hobbs, and you have Ruby Soho and MJF. And then car two, you have CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, Britt Baker, and Christian Cage. How much fun was doing this?
Oh, it was a good time. It was a lot of fun, you know. It's I've actually, you know, been a fan of Carpool Karaoke for a while. Obviously, when it was even just a segment on James Corden's talk show, very entertaining. So it was a lot of fun to be asked to be a part of it and to get there and you're just basically riffing, right? You're just kind of ad-libbing as you go and having some fun and trying to make each other laugh, and in turn, you know, hopefully the audience laughs along with you. It's a good time.
And Christian, then how did you get involved with it? What was it? Was it just showing up one day at AEW and someone asked you, or was it something else that happened?
No, I'm friends with one of the guys in charge of the show, a guy named Eric Pankowski, who used to be a writer for WWE back in the day. And he and I had gotten in touch, and he was interested in and having us on the show and having AEW represented on the show, which I thought was pretty cool. So I brought it to the attention of AEW, and the rest is history. It went from there.
How do you think it went?
It went good. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. It was. You know, from the whole crew and staff that were there to deal with the carpool karaoke, they were all great and very accommodating, and just basically said the same thing. Just said, have fun with it, you know. And that's usually when we get the best footage is when you're just having fun, and that's what we did. We just you got to be the butt of the joke and not be afraid to make fun of yourself sometimes. So that's it's a lot of fun to do shows like this.
Well, Christian, and you're. To embrace the entertainment, the fun side. So what was that you watched it? But what was it like being on the other side of it and being involved in it like that?
Sorry, you cut out there. You froze there, so I missed that whole question.
Okay, so Christian, during your illustrious career, you've been very good in the ring, but you've also embraced the entertainment side, whether it be making fun of yourself or just goofing on others. So you mentioned that you've watched Carpool Karaoke. What was it like, too, now that you were on the other side of it and being involved with it?
Yeah, it was great. I mean, it was a lot of fun. I'm glad I had the opportunity to do it. I think it's always good to be able to branch out and do different things like this and step outside the walls of wrestling for a little bit. And, you know, it's got a big audience. So it also, hopefully put some eyes on AEW product and the big stars and the great shows and that we have going on TNT and TBS. So it was a great platform for everyone to just have a good time. And yeah, that's what we did.
And those shows, AEW Dynamite, which is Wednesday nights, 8 p.m., and also AEW Rampage, which is on 10 p.m. on Friday nights. Yeah. Of course, with NHL playoffs and other playoffs going on, sometimes the time will change a little bit. And, of course, we're going to get into a little NHL hockey.
Sure.
But I do want to talk a little carpool karaoke because this is such a cool thing. And you mentioned when James was doing it on YouTube and doing it on his show, it just went ballistic. It went through the roof. Is there any carpool karaoke that comes to mind for you that he was involved in that you enjoyed?
No, I think the majority of them, I find him to be very entertaining no matter who he's with. And I think that he's just he's got a very engaging personality. Always seems like he's in a great mood and kind of one of those guys that lightens up a room whenever. I've never had a chance to meet him, but like this is just the impression that I get from him, that he's just a funny guy and a witty guy to be around. And I think he, like he was always just going for it in those ones too. Like he was super into everything, you know, you get with the, he would be dancing along and, you know, singing his heart out. So it was, I think, you know, all of them that he did were very entertaining.
Now, what was it like?
I think he had one where he had the entire Foo Fighters band in the car. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, the Foo Fighters. I saw that one too. Yeah. That was awesome. Yeah. I go to Stevie Wonder. I go to when he had Sir Paul McCartney from London, from his hometown. And they went through and did so much stuff there. That was fun too. Foo Fighters are great though. Those guys have so much fun with it. It's just really good. Those are some guys that like to have fun outside of the music.
Yeah, for sure.
And all. Sure. Gosh. So, hey, for you, what was it like being in the car with CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, Britt Baker? And was that the first time you've been in the car with them? Because you pro wrestlers travel on the road all the time.
I never travel with any of them. So it was fun, you know. And like I said, I've obviously known Punk and Bryan for many years. And we've never ridden together, but it was fun. Like, you know, we've always gotten along so it was just fun to get in the car with them and just kind of, you know, I think the four different personalities too is what kind of made our car click. So it was a lot of fun.
Did you learn anything about somebody having some good singing chops out of the other three?
I learned that none of them can sing as good as me.
All right. So, hey, when you're in the car driving and listen, all the years you've spent in pro wrestling, and it is such a grind sometimes, and you're traveling on the road a lot and you're in the car, what is your go-to music? What was your go-to music a few years ago? And what is your go-to music now?
I guess it depends on what kind of day, what time of day it is. You know, if it's during the day and I'm on my way to a show and I'm driving during the day, you know, I like to listen to something a little more upbeat. We just mentioned Foo Fighters. I'm a big, huge fan of the Foo Fighters. Alternative music was kind of my thing. And then if I was driving late at night, I like something a little more, you know, a little more calm, you know, a little more, adult contemporary, maybe. I don't know. I like to listen to like soothing music when I was driving at night. So
maybe a little Christopher Cross or Michael McDonald.
Yeah. I'll sing a little bit of Sailing.
Yes. Business. Oh, it's so good. And hey, Christian, now on this note, with all the different types of pro wrestlers you've driven in the car with over the years, is there someone that you get in the car with and you know already from driving with them, oh no, they're not driving because I don't want them having control of the music?
Man, I don't know. I mean, I traveled with Lance Storm for years and he's got terrible taste in just about everything. So music on down. So it was probably more Lance, even though he actually mostly drove most of the time, but he still never had control of the radio.
That was awesome. So, all right. So a little bit of NHL hockey. We're in the playoff season. Things are going. Come on. You're in Tampa. You're probably a Tampa Bay Lightning fan, two-time defending champs. You're also from Canada. Are you also a hockey fan of one of the Canadian teams?
Well, I just need to point this out now. I'm looking at you're obviously a Panthers homer. You know, you got your Panthers hat on, your shirt. And this was not planned at all, because if you want to – go Bolts, right?
2-0, man. 2-0. Yeah. Last night's game was unbelievable. Looked like it was going to overtime, and then the Lightning struck.
Oh, terrible play by Mackenzie Weegar there. He should have been aware of who was behind him. But it happens, right? I mean, we can play armchair quarterback all we want, but the fact is that the Panthers finished first overall. They won the President's Trophy, so they're very capable of coming back in this series. So it's not over, not by a long shot, but yeah. So I grew up in Toronto, just outside Toronto, a diehard Maple Leafs fan, for my entire life. They've let me down for 48 years. I want to say 48 because the last few years have been very promising. So, I'm very excited about the team and where they're at. It was really tough in the first round because obviously being in Tampa for 21 years, it'd be nice to have that three-peat, which hasn't been done in, gosh, I can't even remember how long, last team to win three in a row.
Maybe Pittsburgh, maybe the Penguins. Pittsburgh.
Might have been. And the, and then I still felt like if Toronto got past Tampa, I still feel like there's a little bit of work to do on their defensive game. So I didn't know if they'd have what it takes to make it all the way, but I felt like if Tampa could get through, they could. And I think they're starting to hit their stride now. Vasilevsky just completely shutting the door in those last couple games in the Leafs. I felt like the Leafs outplayed Tampa in the last, especially in the last couple games. And Vasilevsky just, he's on another planet. You know, when it gets into the playoffs, the guy is just unbelievable. So, you know, it's tough. It's like a 1A, 1B for me as far as favorite teams go. So I couldn't go wrong in the first round. Whoever won, I was going to cheer that team going forward. So I actually went to the game here in Tampa. It was game three where Tampa kind of got blown out. And I was trying not to cheer too loudly when Toronto was. But, again, it was a great series. Seven games, you can't beat it. So playoff hockey is the best. It really is.
And it's different because regular season, how many times have we seen the top teams in the regular season some way, somehow get beat in the first or second round? That's the crazy thing about hockey and all.
Yeah, there always seems to be some sort of upset, you know, or a sleeper team that kind of gets in right at the finish line of the regular season. And then just kind of, they're just firing. Cause the way I see it is, with a lot of the teams that are just kind of scratching and clawing for playoff spots, in their minds, they're playing playoff hockey for the last 2 months, month of the season, trying to make it in. So they're already in that mindset of kind of do or die. So, and I think that's kind of what hurt a couple of years ago when Tampa got swept by Columbus in the first round. I felt like Tampa had nothing to play for, like a month and a half, 2 months before they'd locked up a playoff spot couple months before the playoffs even started. So they really had nothing to play for. So they were just kind of, I felt like, just coasting at that point. Whereas Columbus, they were scratching and clawing. They're basically playing playoff hockey those last couple months, trying to make it in. So they were already in that mind frame, and they got Tampa on their heels, and they couldn't recover. So, but they learned from that and came back and won two straight cups. So it shows what kind of team they are.
Panthers this year, the last few weeks, they had already known what was going to happen. They had already said everything, and they came out flat against Washington, but somehow they were able to get through. I mean, geez, Verhaeghe for them just had an incredible series for them. And then but coming against Tampa, that Duclair's second goal was disallowed, and that was a turning point in the game. And then last night with the play that happened and Mackenzie Weegar just fell asleep and all. But, hey, you mentioned Toronto and Tampa. For you, you said that. I mean, that's the best of both worlds. You got them going in the first round. It's almost like, okay, I'll be sad, but I'll be happy as well, no matter who wins.
Right, right. And if Toronto had won, the thing that would have made me most, like, at least now I can still go to playoff games, you know?
Hey, your friend Eric Young, he's got a cool show now, Dangle Betselli, that he does. It's a podcast, it's a show, it's available all over, but it's all about the NHL hockey season. And things like that. And he mentioned you obviously were a big hockey fan as well and all. So I'm just curious. Now, his is more of a betting show, but they talk about other things, all hockey centric. Yeah. I'm just curious. Would you ever be interested in doing a hockey show? You're a hockey fan. You've watched the game, seen the game, been involved in the game.
Yeah, sure. I would love to, you know, that would be fun to do. Obviously, like, hockey is a passion of mine. And I played it when I was a kid, obviously. I played up to junior. But yeah, I mean, if I had somebody else to kind of, you know, bounce stuff off of and have a good time with it, then yeah, you never say never to anything like that.
Well, Eric said he might try to get you on a guest one time.
Conversation.
Be looking out for that. And hey, Christian, a couple more questions. We'll let you get going here. AEW, so many good things happening with AEW.
Yeah.
I believe the next one is AEW Double or Nothing.
Yep.
And then after that, we've got Forbidden Door, which is an AEW New Japan Pro Wrestling collaboration as well.
Yeah.
What has it been like for you being involved with AEW? And wow, those fans are so passionate.
Yeah, it's been great. And, you know, the thing that I appreciate about AEW is that the fan base is a little more of a hardcore wrestling fan base. And, and that shows every time we go to an arena, the crowd is just electric, you know. And it just, when you hear that kind of response, like even before the show starting, you can hear them rumbling out there. You can hear them rumbling, just waiting, anticipating for the show to start. And that just can't help to get your juices flowing and want you to get out there and perform at a high level. So for me to be out of the ring for as long as I was for 7 years and to come back and have the opportunity that AAW has given me with a platform, it was the right choice and the right place for me to come and have the last few years of my career. And, you know, kind of make up for lost time, you know, and I don't feel like I'm done, not by a long shot. In fact, I feel like like I said, my thing is when I was coming back, it's like if I couldn't come back and be as good as I was, then I had no interest in doing it. I didn't want to be a shell of my former self. And I feel like I'm right there with where I was before I retired. And in a way, you know, my body was kind of preserved there for 7 years, you know, and had a chance to heal up some nagging injuries and things like that. So I feel great. So I'm just incredibly thankful for the opportunity that I have here and to get a chance to get in there and you know, work with some of these younger talents. You know, they're just it's inspiring for me. You know, kind of reinvigorates me as well, like talking to them backstage and have them come up and ask questions and for advice and things like that, to see the passion in their eyes. It just reignites my passion for it as well.
And hey, you're helping with the tag champs.
Yeah, they're great. My Jungle guys, Boy. I think Jungle Boy's got a huge future ahead of him. I was really excited to get a chance to be partnered with them and to kind of be a mentor for them and to guide them, you know, to where they're at now, which is the tag team championships. And, you know, we really are a team. Like we are, like we don't just see each other at the arena and then like, all right, see you next week. Like we talk a lot during the week and we've bounced ideas back and forth and, really created a great bond and friendship with both of them. So, that just makes it more special to what I'm doing now. And I can't wait to see where Jungle Boy goes in the future, because I do think he has a chance to be a face of the company going forward. And Luchasaurus, same thing. The talent this guy has for a guy his size, the way he can move, I mean, the sky's the limit for him as well.
Well, and Christian, another thing too is wrestlers like you and Chris Jericho, Sting, Edge, you guys are still competing at a very high level and have been doing this a while. And now Ric Flair is going to have one last match and do his thing and all. Just what are your thoughts of being able to compete and still do it good at a good level?
Yeah. I mean,
your age.
I mean, it's not like I've said this previously, like it's not lost on me what the opportunity that I have. Like I feel like it's a gift that I've gotten back my career. So I just want to take advantage of it, you know, and especially like when I get out there in front of the AEW, the passionate audiences that we wrestle in front of every single week. I just want to go out there and I want to leave it all out there in the ring, every opportunity that I get. And I just want to have quality, great matches that stand the test of time at the end of the day. And, you know, I feel like I've had some real good matches since I came back, and ones that I'm proud of, I guess, as the kids say these days, some bangers, as I guess what they're calling them now. So I guess I've had a couple bangers.
Oh, and we're going to let you go. But Christian, what are your thoughts too of Ric Flair having that one final match? It seems like it's going to be a really cool weekend. The Four Horsemen reuniting, it really well put together.
Yeah, I'm sure, you know, it'll be a big event. You know, obviously, you know, Ric Flair, arguably one of the greatest, if not the greatest ever do it. So it's I'm sure that the interest is definitely going to be there for him to go in there and see the Nature Boy do it one more time. So you know, I just hope he does a nice little strut, maybe throws in a figure four, and it'll send the crowd home happy, I'm sure.
Do you think we'll get the Lightning versus Calgary and Bret the Hitman Hart?
I don't know. We'll have to set something up if it came down to that. We'll have to figure something out.
And last but not least, do you still keep in touch with Dos Conquistadores?
From time to time, you know, they don't have cell phones, so I got to write them letters in the mail. But they, you know, they sometimes take their time to get back. But every now and again, I'll talk to them. Yeah.
Well, Carpool Karaoke Season 5, you're going to get two cars full of AEW stars. It's going to be awesome. It's on Apple TV Pluses, which premieres on May 27th. It's going to be a good time. And gosh, I'll leave you with this. MJF, when I saw his name on there, that one threw me, because he's so in his character realm, and to have it part of Carpool Karaoke, it's just going to be great to see, and see all of you involved in this.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if he just sat there miserable in the back seat and didn't say anything. So
you hit the nail on the head. That's exactly it. Well, Christian Cage, thank you so much. Thank you for what you have done, what you are doing, and what you will do. And hey, for me, hopefully the Panthers will come back, but we'll see what happens. If not, good for you, and go Tampa for you, Christian.
Go Bolts.